Hey Design Nation, in this session, you're going to learn how to use dynamic components in SketchUp. Hey, so we're going to learn about how to use SketchUp's dynamic components. So to be clear, we're not going to learn how to make them, we're just going to learn how to find some and how to operate the ones that you do find. So I just want to make that very clear. And actually, this is SketchUp, the free version. So you actually can't make SketchUp components in the free version. You can only use them. So this is going to illustrate my point pretty well. So if you click on Susan when you open up a vanilla version of SketchUp, this is actually the 2012 version. So if you click on Susan, you know, she sort of, you would typically think that she's sort of a dumb component, right? You can copy her and you can change one version of her, and it'll add to the other, right? It'll change that. So typically that's how components are used. But a lot of people don't know that Susan is actually a dynamic component. So if you go to toolbars, view toolbars, and you scroll down, you'll see that there's a dynamic components option. So if you click that, it'll pop up this little window. And this window has a finger, which is the interact with dynamic components. It's a drop down list, which is component options. And this grayed out box is component attributes. And it says pro only because this is what you would use if you're going to make your own dynamic components. But since we're just going to operate our dynamic components, we're just going to use these first two anyway. So I'm going to go ahead and dock this over to the side. And I'm going to open this component options. So you can see I don't have anything selected, and it says no components selected. Select one or more components to view their options. So I'm going to select Susan. It actually brings up this dialog. And it basically says Susan is a member of the SketchUp development team, blah blah blah, and you can change the color of her shirt. So you can change it to red. Or, so if you select Susan, you can change it to any of these colors. They've programmed this in here. You can actually change this to any color you want if you were to program it. It could be a random color. It could be sort of anything you want. It could be a material too. But if I click this interact with dynamic components, you can actually change your shirt just by clicking too, and it'll cycle through the colors. So I'm actually going to show you some more dynamic components. I'm going to delete Susan. So if you go to Window Components, and I'll pop up your component components window, and you can see any thumbnail that has this little logo in the corner is a dynamic component. So if you open up, if you import one of these, it's going to have a parameter. It's going to have something that you can edit. So this is saying use the scale tool to resize the width of the bench. So it doesn't have anything specifically in the component options, but it is still dynamic. So basically, depending on whoever made it and how they made their dynamic component, there are going to be different options available. So maybe you won't be able to use the component options, but maybe you'll be able to use the interact tool. Or maybe, like this is saying, if you hit S, there's a scale tool. So you'll notice that there are only two grips on this. And if you drag, it'll lengthen the bench. So this is, you know, sort of all this one does is you can lengthen the bench. And it just spaces these out evenly, so you can change the size of it. And it doesn't, like, it looks like it's going to make everything fat, but it'll resize everything to be what you would want it to look like. So I'm going to delete this and, oop, actually went into the component. Click delete. I'm going to show you the this wall. So the framing wall is something that, you know, if you're in architecture, you've done before. You can actually change the spacing to 24-inch spacing. You can change the height. You can change the length. So, you know, if you want to have a 12-foot wall, you can do that. You can change the length. So if you know specifically you want a 60-foot wall, it'll do that. Or if you sort of have what you want and you want to just mess around, you can hit the S to scale, and you can just drag it. And it's really nice for that. So, you know, and it has 2x6, 2x4. If you wanted to, you could edit this and you could make it metal studs. It's just really nice in sort of what it can do. And it makes things a little bit quicker than it would be to model everything on your own. And one other thing that I want to show before I end this video is cars. So the best thing I have my own cars that I use. I don't use this car. But really, dynamic components, if you're using a lot of the same component and you want to just change one or two things, dynamic components are fantastic. So for cars in renderings and things like that, you don't want to have a ton of different cars, because cars inherently are pretty heavy models. So you want to try to minimize the different components of cars that you have. And if you want to change the color of the same car to just give a little bit of variety, it's tough to do without increasing your file size anyway. So what I've actually learned is that through using dynamic components, you can use one car and change the color of it to give a lot of different variety. And by shifting the direction of the car, whether it's facing forward or backwards, like if you're doing a parking lot and some cars pulled in and some cars backed in, and the variety of color changes, you can get a really dynamic feel without having a ton of different models. So this is kind of like a fancy little car that they made. The doors open. It's kind of cute. And actually, when you click on, I think the tires rotate, yeah. So you click on this. This is probably way fancier than you need. And this is just sort of showcasing what dynamic components can do. So this pops up these little spheres, and you can click on them, and it'll change the car to that color, and then the spheres disappear. So that's kind of a nice interactive option. It's kind of finicky, so you'll notice when I copy this car over, and the first time that I click it, it'll pop up these spheres over here. So it's just kind of finicky that way. So I would say the more that you can keep your components simple, the better. But this sort of shows you what you can do, and this is the same component, and you're just sort of changing one parameter and saving on your file size. If you have a question about how to use dynamic components, feel free to leave it in the comments below. And you can follow the link in the description over to our website at designerhacks.com, and there will be a write-up of this video, and it will include some links to download some of the dynamic components that I use all the time. So if you want to get a quick inside look at sort of what I use and how I use dynamic components, that's a good place to do it. And as always, thanks for listening, and I'll check you next time.